Right, hello and welcome back to Elden Ring. Now, looking at last time, so I've actually gone and done a bit of, well, I guess for lack of a better term, some research on the boss, since it seems to be absolutely decimating me. So, the issue that I'm having with the boss, so the first thing is, we're doing a nice bit of damage, but we're rarely getting attacks in. Though, something that's worth noting is, whilst we are getting attacks in, we're doing a nice chunk of damage. This is something interesting. We're actually having a massive damage reduction. Apparently, the one strength of this boss is it has an 80% reduction to any incoming fate damage. So basically, say we were going to do 100 faith damage, we would only do instead do 20. Now I don't know how that works with the blasphemous blade, but I'm beginning to understand as to why that was the only weapon that hurt it. So even though we're thinking, oh, we could upgrade a different weapon and level it up. Not really. So, as we know, the winged scythe literally is holy damage, specifically holy damage, right? Because of that, while it does a nice chunk of damage and a nice amount of blood loss, it will not do that much damage. So that near almost, what's that? Yeah, that's literally a 345 holy damage. Yeah, it's gonna do like about 45 of it ish. It will not do very much of that damage. The physical will hurt, but the best, no. The other weapon we have though. Find it. Here we are. So the blasphemous blade. Now we have on this we do physical damage, but while it is holy scaling B, well, faith scaling B, it doesn't do it in holy damage, it does it in fire damage. So we've inadvertently bypassed the holy damage reduction that we get on the boss. But our other weapons won't do this. The Holy Uchi Katana. Now, the scythe we can't change. We can't change the Ash of War. The Uchi Katana we could change, and then we'd have a fast attacking weapon. That's potentially something to try, but maybe not the game change we're looking for. Seeing as we couldn't fully upgrade it, we can't find the stones. Well, the smithing stones to finish fully upgrading it, so it will probably just do reduced damage. It's probably worth just hanging on to this, because if we get one hit in with this, it will be like 3 or 4 with Uchi Katana. So probably still worth sticking with this. But then, now, a few changes in strategy though might still be in order here. So. Okay, sure. So, we know that our weapon is affected. Well, you know, big deal. That doesn't help. But, now, the reason we're losing health in the fight is because it inflicts blood flame. The incantation we were trying to get to work on the Uchi Katana, literally in the second phase, he has that equipped permanently on his weapons. Right? Now, interesting. Okay, so that's why we're losing health. Now we know. It's basically, we'll do a damage tick over time until it wears off. We can tell when it's happening because we'll literally be on red fire coming off of our character. So we can keep an eye for that. But, now this is a bit of a few useful pieces of information here. Now, given that those go through our shield, our options are simple. We can either block We can either dodge roll out of them to not get hit by them, I think that's basically it. We can either just, the real only option here is to kind of just either dodge them or just do not get hit by them. That's basically the set of options here. Now, that means that, well, if we're not necessarily wanting to be blocking, well, then there's not. We still might want to block, but we're certainly not going to be sending magic spells back at people. We can probably drop to a different shield. So we can probably drop back to a basic shield that just gives us 100% physical and a few resistances, such as, yes, the grass shield here. Best yet, it has no skill, and so when we press the L2 button, we can make it just use our actual blade ability. So it makes combat a little bit less cumbersome, mashing buttons and things. Bad, okay, but it reduces our weight, right? Now we've lost a lot of our character's weight, right? Seeing as it's not going to be, hey, let's go for maximum tankiness in this one, what I'm thinking might be a better idea would be to actually reduce our weight up to the point where we are no longer on a heavy load. I'm just going to see how much that would be, to be fair. I'm actually uncertain. So we're on a light load now. We might try it on for size, but we'll see how it goes. Right, let's start from the top. Another thing as well. Supposedly, the damage we deal in the second phase is classed as magic damage. So I still think that the physical damage, because they do still do physical damage, is important. This doesn't give us much HP recovery, it's very minor. So I think that this will probably do more in terms of damage negation. Alternatively, we may be able to put the grass jar on. Not the grass jar, the arsenal jar. Where is it? Yeah. Great jar's arsenal. Massively bump up our load so that what's considered a light load would be significantly less. Oh, sorry, significantly more. But I'm not sure yet. We'll see what we can do. Equipping some heavy armor will immediately put us into intermediate. So we couldn't, for example, put the veterans on. Bloodhound stuff is pretty light. Looks like I might have to go without any kind of helmet boss results. Yeah, we should check lower boss a little bit. can get to Light Lord here. I might only try this once or twice. Yeah. Feels a lot more mobile. Said, I'm a bit fashion conscious, so to try in the red. It matches the little tucks on the top a bit better there. Let's go with that. Oh, and last of all, very nearly forgot. I probably should have thought this before doing that cast, but the item we got, here it is, the Blasphemous Claw. How do I have the front? Oh, yeah, do it. Equipment. There. Use it apparently, so it's not a weapon, it's an item. You use it like you would a book. Now, this part of the fight will be a lot more difficult. Him putting his hand into the ground like that means a spell is coming up. I'd rather not fight on the ground there, knowing the entryway. Well, we've got about as far as we normally do, with the hand still intact. So that is blood flame and all of that. When we see his weapon shine gold, not just a particle effect on it, but it shines gold, the whole thing. And we'll see a shimmer go along the blade. That's when we use the Blasphemous Claw. If he hits us within that window, suffering from blood flame blade a little bit. Armor isn't everything in this fight. In fact, given that he deals magical damage in the second phase and literally bleeds it dry, dubious as to how helpful it is at all. And then, of course, you have to consider, well, going by that logic, if it's not really much use at all, why bother with any at all? So that's why we're swapping to the Light Lord. I mean, having less than this will not be of any benefit anyway, so as long as it's a Light Lord, we're fine. Yeah? Just a Light Lord with 100% physical negation shield. That's all we need. And that's all we're going to have. But the additional mobility was definitely of use. It might be an idea, actually. Because I've just, like, thrown on what seemed alright. But maybe worth putting more magical resistance items on. Like, is there something around this tier? Not to pull the motion out. Something around this weight, about 5-ish, that will have significantly better magical resistances. Let's swap it to compare. I mean, obviously heavier things will, but we want to avoid heavy. We've got a few pounds to spare for a line load, but we don't need resistances. That might work. Surprisingly. That might be better. Others are not so much. Noble's travel guard, garb, that's pretty good. And then any more we're going on into macro, well, medium core. Okay, the gauntlets, we need to see significantly better from the weight. Honestly, the Godric soldiers and the foot soldiers still. Better. This one we have the weight to spare. Magic, fire, so 1, 5, well they're all being in the 100, so 59, 79, 35, 59, right? So, yeah, not bad, 59, 79, 35, 59. We swap that out, 59, 79, 35, 59, right? Defense, damage, damage negation, maybe I'm looking for that. No, change. Must be doing something, but I'm not entirely certain as to exactly what. What would it take to drop this down? Throw this back on. Yeah, we'll try that. Okay. Did they just fall down? Didn't know that they would actually do that. Honestly, I'm tempted to just give up on this guy. Mostly because of my nimble was stupid to fall off the damn edge. I mean, I've now not got the next five parts. This guy can smack me with his stupid high damage abilities. But it's fine though, we don't normally get out of it for long this part. I hate that. I hate most of them. Hey, I'll just use my insta-kill move. Thanks. Right. Let's go give him a love tap back. Why does it keep reducing my health at the start? I'm not going to go in with a chunk of health missing. It's got to be a bug. Not noticed it till up top. I wonder if it's new or if it's like specific to do with maybe an item I've got on, or if perhaps it's to do with that site of grace specifically. Who knows? But it's doing it. And it's mildly annoying. Minutes there, we can just get those hits in quicker. Probably 3 hits from killing him. You can still see the weapons shining in that, but that's going to be a difficult task. That's going to be a tall order to get an actual parrying on him. Mostly because it's like, well, if you accidentally think he's going in for one and you think you've got the timing right and you're just out by a millisecond. Well, his attack seems to kill you, so good luck. I'd much rather have that minute distract him by then just bash him, or well, just blast him from a few meters away with the ability. I'd much rather that be the way that we take him out. So that he turns the next stage of the fight with the hatchet. That might give us an extra bit of. That was a good dodge. No, I said heal, come on. Oh my god, for that one, nearly gone then. And we're in blood flame. Constant healing. Yeah, we're just, we can't even get a bloody attack. Because I'm just constantly having to fucking heal. Ridiculous. Once it gets you on the ropes, it's like you're being suppressed, basically. You can't even get up against it. The moment he finds an opening, it's just, right, you're getting hit, and you're getting hit, and you're getting hit, and you're getting hit. Because you need to find a moment to heal, and the moment you decide to heal is the moment he'll go in for another attack. And then he'll just hit you again, so you need to heal, so then he'll attack again, and you need to heal, and you just waste your blasts, and you're gonna die. You can't ignore the damage because of the blood flame effects on his weapon, because you know that means if you ignore the attack, you'll just die, basically. If he hits you, you'll just die. Very frustrating fight. Just a beat. It's annoying because it kind of counters my entire bloody build. Oh, what's my build? Well, it's just armor and blocking shit and reflecting spells. got him. Is I'm gonna bet that that's some kind of god killing weapon then. Is it? Is that a weapon or is that a wound? I'm just wondering, it looked like it was gonna form a sword. Well, we died anyway. So that's the end of the series.
The rune of death is unbound. And the lands between are shrouded by death's dark fate. But the flames will also burn the impenetrable thorns.
Oh, that's getting worse. That's spreading.
Farewell, it is then.
It's lopsided too. Yeah, that ain't
You'll
good.
You'll be Elden Lord yet.
That Ritala in the round table. Plot twist. We were her all along. I mean, seriously, I think it is literally the same outfit, but yeah. Isn't that the capital? I'm thinking it is, yeah. Oh. Oh, we exploded it. Well. Imagine we got. Oh yeah, we got a few rooms. We'll do a bit of strength, a bit of faith, and like I said, we'll just bump them all up to, yeah, just start bumping things up a bit. Let's put our stuff back on. Normal, our big anti-mage shield, and we will no longer need this. Back to normal. Right, now. We are at Capital of Ash. But before we go back, how many rooms? 90,000. Will this give me enough? 35. It's a bit close. Just shy of about another 9, basically. Is this 7.5, if I remember? Yeah. Is that enough? It is. Right. Our strength is level 35 now. And we will no longer be leveling that up until we've got faith to 35, and we'll also put vigor up to 40. I wanted to read the message, god damn it. Right. Why is it always sadness? No. No. Bad. So we need to get to the barrier of thorns, I suppose, then, don't we? And before we do that, let's just check in, and then I think we'll call it an episode there. Oh. We are not doing too good here, are we? We are really not looking healthy. Oh! Okay. Have they all fled? I'm assuming they've all fled. Yeah, I would probably have fled at this point. Stone 3, 4, 7, 8. Grave Glowwort. Ghost Glowworts, but not the ones we need. Oh. I guess these are items we could have got from people in the capital that have perished, I suppose, in the flames. Possibly merchants and so on, or maybe this is from the beast clergyman, maybe it's the other stuff that we couldn't get from him. Increases physical damage negation now, that's big. Okay, that's worth buying. And Further's cookbook. How much would that all set me back? Bit, I'll admit, very decent bit. We may wish to get some runes and come back here on the next site of grace. Looks like we'll need a lot. I don't want to just burn through golden runes. I mostly use those to top me off for when I need to level up. I want to bank a large amount of runes. Her to talk to there. Suppose we'll start with her.
I see. You're here for some spirit tuning.
I mean, I was actually here to check up on you to make sure you hadn't, you know, spiraled into depression and thrown yourself into the fireplace next to you, but sure, spirit tuning, that's why I'm here. Don't arouse her suspicion. Don't want to set her off. And is this still just like where that guy died? Whose name has long since just like evacuated my memory. I just know him as D. Which is not a good... What was his name? I don't know. But he was all about the D.
In this ash, I can smell the ancient storm. It reminds me of my first harp.
Unfortunately, the ash of the building around her then that was on fire. Right. Now, let's see what Hugh has to say.
Oh, I must be a blacksmith now. Let's go smithing. Could you tell me what happened? Why is the round table burning? Why does that girl weep for me? Oh. Have I forgotten something of dire importance?
That is called smoke inhalation. You're dying. You probably want to leave. You probably really want to leave. I must craft you the most, you know, the mightiest of weapons. It's like, guy, just like, mark somewhere on the map. I'll meet you there. You know, just take your equipment. Monstrosity. Oh, I could have touched one this entire time and I never did. Oh, I wonder why I never thought to touch those things. Ugh. She may be dead, but we can still do this apparently. A colossal sword. Which does destined death. With strength, dexterity and faith scaling. Ooh. Or black blade. Black blade spinning slash that emits waves of light. Faith required 46. Jesus Christ. If you're doing a faith only build, maybe, but things we already had have a ridiculously good weapon. This is one that I'd actually like to duplicate, because I think I could probably use both. Things you can duplicate used ones, so for now, we'll get the big blade. And we get, oh wow, 12.8. Ah, it's good, but as good as it may be, it is not as good as Redan's. It's not as good as the veterans either. Absolutely not. So it's good, but it's not astounding. Looks kind of cool though. Seems like a midway point between, say, something like the Crucible Knight and Redan's gear. Because really that's what a lot of the armour is, it's just side grades mostly. Heavier is better generally speaking, but plate normally means physical, robes and things normally mean magical resistance, weight equals better, better attributes overall. Just basically, isn't it? Now, that said though, I think that's going to do it for the episode. I'm just making myself look imposing. Oh look, there's fire and everything under there. Oh lovely. So, we will leave it there. Well, we'll not leave it there. We'll leave it over here. Where is it? Not there. Yeah, we moved back into here, didn't we? I've been up there for ages, actually. Okay. The capital of Ash. I think that's going to do it for the episode. Like I said, so next time we'll be looking to try and get to now I don't know how much there's going to be here in the way of items and things, because it is meant to be the destroyed version of the capital, which we've already ransacked, but they'll probably put a few things about, I would imagine. However, we'll need to get to those doors and open them. That seems to be our mission now. Not much else left to do, so we'll head toward that. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time for that.